But then Ligeti himself rewrote it in 1953 for wind quintet. And today it is one of our most treasured pieces in the wind quintet repertoire. So the next piece we are about to play was actually arranged by one of the quintet members, Cody Hallquist, our horn player. And so I will turn the stage over to him to speak a little bit about his arrangement.
Okay, moving right along. I am Cody Hallquist, a French horn player. And I arranged this next piece, Overture to Nabucco. Another fun fact, this opera quite literally saved Verdi's career. In the 2 years between 1838 and 1840, he wrote an opera that was very poorly received, and he lost both of his infant children and his wife. Naturally, he was very depressed by all of that and swore off composing forever. But luckily for him and us, the director of the La Scala Opera House thought that was a terrible idea and gave him this libretto depicting the Jewish enslavement by the ancient Babylonian king Nabucco. Verdi was very impressed by the libretto, and after a little more prodding, he finally set it to music, and the opera was wildly popular, establishing him at the forefront of Italian opera composers. This was a really fun piece to kind of take the full orchestration and sort of funnel it into the five voices here on the stage. But we're pretty happy with how it turned out. We hope you are too. Without further ado, Overture to Nabucco.
Thank you. next piece on our program, Martin Bresnick's Just Time. And you'll see, as everybody is getting set up, there's some extra challenges to this piece. Felice will be playing that gigantic alto flute. Lydia is going to be playing the English horn. Ixby has the bass clarinet. And Cody has some really wild solos that you'll hear. And it's my challenge to speak about this piece. So one of our goals as a quintet is to explore music written by Yale composers. And we're very lucky that Martin Bresnick wrote this piece, and we actually had the opportunity to play it for him last week. And so I'll tell you a little bit about what insight he gave us into the piece. So he compared the piece to Da Vinci's Vitruvian Man, which is the man standing like this, minus the bassoon, enclosed in a circle. And this drawing is really famous for a few reasons, one of which is that it's extremely well proportioned. And that comes through in this piece by the rhythmic proportions. Another important part of this drawing is its Renaissance symbolism. So the man in Renaissance sort of symbolized all of the universe or all of nature. And that comes through in the piece in the tuning systems. So you're gonna hear some notes that might sound really out of tune, especially from Cody, and it's not his fault. they're part of the natural harmonic series. So Cody, would you play a harmonic series for us? Yeah, congratulations. So he's gonna be doing a lot of that, and sometimes we're going to play notes that fit into the harmonic series, and sometimes we're going to play how we normally do in just intonation, hence the title. And speaking of the title, Martin Bresnick also wants us and you to be able to love this piece without thinking about all of this sort of philosophical stuff. And I'll leave you with how he ends his program note about the piece, which is, "Just time is just music."
Thank you. Thank you.
mentioned, the previous piece by Martin Bresnick incorporates a lot of ideals from the Renaissance era. However, the next three pieces that we are going to be playing are actually from the Renaissance era. So we don't have a lot of pieces for woodwind quintet by Renaissance composers, mostly because the poor clarinet wasn't invented until 100 years later. So we decided, after our coach, Mr. Purvis, told us to explore some of his arrangements of some Monteverdi and Gesualdo madrigals to, you know, look at our own. So Nelly and I have picked a couple of our favorites, and we've arranged them for our quintet, and we're going to be playing them in a set of three, one of which is our coach, Mr. Purvis's. So the most important thing about the madrigals is the setting of the text. And so the original text in these has to deal with the pain of lovers parting, and then the sorrow of spurned love, and then the young lovers in the springtime. So we hope you enjoy our set of Monteverdi madrigals.
Thank you.
Theme song. This piece is called La Nouvelle Orléans, or New Orleans, and it depicts a series of vignettes of the city, which starts with the bustling French Quarter, and then moves along into the funeral procession, which in New Orleans is actually more of a celebration. And then it continues to the Mardi Gras party, and finishes with a bluesy jazz number, played by yours truly, and I get to act like a trombone player in a big jazz band and slide around and do things I don't normally get to do on the oboe in orchestra. And it's especially fun for me to play because my grandfather was actually a reed player in a Dixieland jazz band called the Temperance Seven, so I feel a little bit like I'm connecting back to my roots when I play the end of this piece. So we hope that you enjoy it as much as we have fun playing it. La Nouvelle Orléans.
Thank you. Thank you.